Namaskar to all of you. Welcome on my part. And I also welcome with profound respect our state president, Mr. Lakshman ji, and my friend from my Yuva Morcha days, Krishna Reddy, the leader of the house on behalf of the BJP. Friends, when we came to power in the year 2014, our Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji had said every year on the completion of our government, we'll go to the people and explain what we have done. After first year, we came visiting different parts of India. I also came to Andhra Pradesh at that point in time. This is the fourth year. My journey began from my city of Patna, then Bhubaneswar. Yesterday I was in Varanasi. Today I'm in Hyderabad. Therefore, tomorrow I'm in Muzaffarpur. And finally, my journey would end in Ranchi. Similarly, all the ministers are in various parts of the country, where you meet all of you, give a visual presentation as to what we have done, take your questions. It is a new initiative of public engagement. And as our Prime Minister said in my introduction, that Digital India is under my care as an IT Minister. The vision of the Prime Minister remain digitally connected and also remain physically connected. So this whole tour is a part of that physical connection with the people of India and also conveying our message to them. Friend, the format would be about 3 to 4 minutes, I'll make my initial comments. Then there will be a 15-minute slideshow, which you will see on the screen here and here. What exactly we have done will speak about in various aspects of development. Couple of minutes, my concluding remarks, then open to your question. That's how we'll go. Now, my distinguished friends of the media, 4 years down, what is the concrete achievement of our government? Number one, a government of transparency. The doors of Delhi government are closed for the brokers and middlemen. You cannot point a single instance where government decisions have been influenced by mala fide consideration, extraneous consideration. Be it a spectrum allocation, or coal block allocations, or airwave allocations, or highway constructions, tender bidding, all are either online or done in a transparent manner, which our government's motto is. In fact, there is a principle governing Delhi decision making. Whatever is doable shall be done, regardless of whatever you say. Whatever is not doable shall not be done, regardless of whatever you do. And that's how we have worked. The second, India today is emerging as a global power. And our Prime Minister is a respected, dignified global leader. India's voice matters. You have seen something very interesting, be it America, be it Europe, be it Southeast Asia, be it ASEAN countries, the PM is visiting them. India's voice is treated with a lot of respect. And I would give you two clear instances. The President of China, President Xi, asked Prime Minister Modi to visit and have informal dialogue for 2 days. President Putin of Russia, after re-election, invites Modi ji, in spite of Karnataka, please come. Let's talk for a day. Drives him around personally and comes to see him off at the airport for the first time a Russian president has done. Second, Afghanistan gives its equivalent of Bharat Ratna to Modi ji. So does Iraq, so does Iran, so does Saudi Arabia, so does UAE, so does Muscat. And the King of Jordan comes to India and makes a speech against Islamic terrorism. Pakistan today stands isolated in the fight against terrorism. And when SAARC was to be held in Pakistan, and when Pakistan refused to give a clear indication of firm action on terrorism, except Pakistan, all the non-SAARC countries backed out, led by India. This is the growing clout of India as far as foreign policy is concerned. Thirdly, the growing economic clout of India. The highest ever FDI, India is recipient. The highest ever foreign reserve, India is in possession. World Bank, IMF, Modi, Harvard think tank, all are saying India is the fastest growing economy. And next year it may touch 7.3 to 7.5. That is the economic clout of India happening. Fourthly, the motto of the Prime Minister has been to reform in order to transform. And in this process, technology is playing a crucial role. Digital India, Make in India, Skill India, Startup India are all game-changing programs. I'll just give you two, three instances before I come to the slide presentation. The Jan Dhan Aadhaar Mobile Trinity, a new invention which the world is experiencing. We opened 31 crore Jan Dhan account of the poor, which means 55% of the global bank account open. My journalist friends, what is the digital profile of India? A population of 1.25 crore plus has 121 crore mobile phones. In the last 4 years, we have added mobile phones in India equal to the population of France and Italy. 121 crore Aadhaar and the Jan Dhan account. We linked the three and started sending all the welfare measures, Manrega payment, gas subsidy, kerosene subsidy, ration subsidy to the poor. Close to 3,80,000 crores have been sent. It keeps on changing every day. And how much we have saved? 90,000 crores, which used to be pocketed by the middlemen and fictitious claimants. Digital governance is good governance. You recall late Rajiv Gandhi's observations. I send rupees 1 from Delhi, and only 15 paisa reaches the villages of Andhra Pradesh. In Narendra Modi government, rupees 1,000 is sent to the poor, it reaches the poor, then to the bank account. Having e-hospital, nearly 230 hospitals are e-hospital. You can get reservations to Delhi sitting in Hyderabad if you want to go to AIMS. Soil health card, 13 crore farmers are using that. E-NAM, close to 80 lakh farmers are having digital connect with 500 agriculture mandis. E-scholarship, 1.5 crore students have got 5,000 crore plus scholarship, digitally speaking. This digital highway is great, creating great waves, and Digital India today is a very powerful message gone to the world. I also handle electronics. One day the Prime Minister asked me how much mobiles are manufactured in India. When we had come to power, there were only two factories in India. Only two. Now 4 years, we have 120 factories manufacturing mobile phones in India, including in your state, adjoining state, Noida, Bengal, all over the country. And from 19,000 crore revenue, we are producing 22 crore mobile phones worth 1,32,000 crores in March last year. Digital highway with natural highway. Earlier, the national highway was being constructed 27 kilometer per day. Now it is 64 kilometer per day or around that. Rural roads, 39 to 40 kilometers per day, 160 kilometers per day. Prime Minister said 18,000 villages are left where no energy has reached. Before the deadline today, we have covered all the non-electrical visits where there was no energy. About 4.5 crore households are left. And we have taken a mission mode to complete that by the year end. How we are creating other infrastructure? From 1947 till 2014, remember, 1947 till 2014, 6 crore 25 lakh village toilets were constructed. In 4 years, we have constructed 7 crore 25 lakhs. That is the mission mode in which we work. Optical fiber. In 3 years of Manmohan Singh government, 358 kilometer of optical fiber was laid in the National Optical Fiber Program. We have laid 2,42,000 kilometers in 4 years. And 1 lakh plus gram panchayats have become optical fiber enabled. By the year end, all the 2,50,000 will be done. This is how we are changing the infrastructure of the country, railways, others you will see when I go to the presentation. But our Prime Minister has said, my government will work for the poor, for the underprivileged, for the farmers. One of the highest allocations for farmer has been done, I'll just show from the slides, 11 lakh crore in terms of credit, 50,000 crore in terms of irrigation, etc. I'll show you that. This whole soil health card plus coverage of Fasal Bima Yojana in case of distress reduced from 50% destruction to 33%. But what is more important is equity. We are just going to launch the Ayushman Bharat, 5 lakh insurance cover to 50 crore Indians, the highest ever medical insurance in the world. Apart from dialysis, lowering the stent price for the heart and the knee replacement, your prices under control of various essential drugs through Indradhanush Yojana. So you will see from agriculture to the poor to the others, we have changed that. I just talked about Aadhaar because a lot of questions are asked about Aadhaar. I would like to clarify it here. What is the basic difference between Dr. Manmohan Singh Aadhaar and Narendra Modi Aadhaar? Manmohan Singh Aadhaar was without any legislative backing. If I can use the Hindi word, Aadhaar was Niradhaar. What we have done? We have passed a proper parliamentary law giving due regard to privacy, safety and security. And the provisions are so tough that even I, as an IT and law minister of India, if I disclose my biometrics in an authorized manner, I can be prosecuted. Companies can be prosecuted. It can be disclosed only and only in case of compelling national interest. When the Government of India, through a joint secretary, files a proper application affirmed by the Cabinet Secretary, Law Secretary, and IT Secretary. Let me show you something. This is my Aadhaar. What does it contain? My photograph, I'm a male, and my permanent Patna address. It does not contain my religion, my community, my caste, my medical record, my educational record, by which I can be profiled. But what the system keeps, my fingerprint and my biometrics, safe and secure. And how does it work? We do 3 crore authentication every day, every second. 121 crore, I told Aadhaar. 80 crore bank account linked to Aadhaar. If I go to the bank, I give my Aadhaar number, he will ask and he will confirm this number matches the biometrics of Ravi Shankar Prasad. That's all. They don't know for what purpose it has been asked. But why linking with bank is important? In case of money laundering, they have, I'll just explain that in 2 minutes' time. I don't know who opened this account of mine, it's not my account, in which the slush money has come. You can disown the PAN card, but you cannot disown your digital identity, namely the fingerprint and the iris. Homegrown technology by India, Indian scientists, I must applaud them. Two last issues, and then I'll go to the presentation. The Narendra Modi government has the courage to take bold decisions. We did surgical strike. Pakistan was responded. And today our army people have been told very clearly, you will not attack first. But if there is attack from across, you need not ask anyone. And you have seen tough measures are doing their own resonance. But how did Prime Minister respond? First, tell the Pakistani people that about 40, 50 corpses are lying. You please go and collect it, and then came to the media. Surgical strike to safeguard India's integrity, and surgical strike to make India honest. You may have heard about demonetization. 1,500 notes, 14 lakh crore have returned. But they are now have an identity who has deposited it and he has to pay tax. Let me tell you some very interesting figures. Only 1.5 lakh people deposited 5 lakh crore. 1.5 lakh people deposited 5 lakh crore. 3.6 lakh people deposited 10 lakh each. We said, no, we have to pay tax. Notices went. And 6,500 crore they have paid tax. All undeclared money earlier. We have deregistered 3 lakh companies. Mark 3 lakh company. Who were they? One house having 100 company. One company having 2,000 bank accounts. And the most interesting was one company, it has 2,000 bank accounts. In one account, there was no money. It deposited 4,000 crore in 1 week and withdrew 4,000 crore in 1 week. I hope that speaks a lot as to how India was being run. We had the courage of conviction to deregister all those companies. We have brought in far-reaching laws, Money Laundering Act changed, Benami Act was made effective. And you have seen this whole issue of your Insolvency Act, big fish is also being netted. Bhushan Steel, 36,000 crores public money, and now it has been recovered through a proper bidding process. So structural changes are happening. When I was speaking before Hyderabad journalist friends, Hyderabad is an IT city of the country. Today, India's IT ecosystem is rising very fast. India is becoming the biggest digital market of the world. Facebook has the biggest footprint in India. Twitter has the biggest footprint in India. Your WhatsApp movement, the biggest footprint in India. Now you see even the e-commerce is rising in India. Amazon and others are coming. I remember when I had come to Bangalore after becoming the minister in 2014 to meet the IT giants, including companies from Hyderabad, NASCOM is called. When I came out, large number of boys from Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Bihar, Rajasthan, UP, MP were standing outside to meet me. And they said, sir, kindly do something that we can revert to our small villages and towns. I came with a BPO in the small towns of India. We give bridging finance. If you go to the small towns. Friends, I can happy to tell you that today BPO movement has started in Kohima, in Imphal, in Dibrugarh, in Guwahati, in Patna, Muzaffarpur, Karimnagar, Chittur, 91 BPOs in 27 states of India, rising further. How the digital ecosystem is changing. There's a big common service center movement, about 2,91,000, including 10,000 in the state of Telangana, who are giving digital delivery of services, young boys and girls, 200 services they are giving. About 1 million, 10 lakh people are working. From digital India to agriculture, to education, technology, more IIMs, more IITs, more central schools, more universities, to highway, to information highway, to India's pride globally. That has been the record of India in the last 4 years. I must conclude with a caveat. I will never say everything is okay. India has developed completely. India is on the path of a robust delivery, robust development with aspiration. And we wish to continue this march further. These are my initial comments. Now let's start for the presentation, and thereafter I'll take questions. Yes, start, please. 12 per year, 1 rupee per month. Please hold on. Jeevan Jyoti Bina, 5.22 crore people, and other. And the most is the bottom one. PM Vyaya Vandana Yojana for elderly people, 8% of interest assured for 10 years. That is the PM Vyaya for the elderly people, pension holders. Next. The OBCs, minorities. Yes, next. India's power, global power. Next. India's GDP, you can see 31% between 2013 and 2017, while the global GDP increased by only 4%. India rated highly investment destination. Go ahead. Next. Yoga becomes global. India's soft power. Yoga is inscribed on the representative list of intangible cultural heritage of humanity in the UNESCO. Today, yoga is being held in Saudi Arabia, in China, in Muscat, in UAE. Yoga has become a mass movement for wellness and also inner peace. That is our contribution to soft power. Next. Climate change, you may have seen the Solar Energy Alliance and other alliance we did in the COP21. And here I would like to mention one example. Kindly stop for a moment. You know, climate change is a big dialogue which goes for months to all the heads of state go. In 2015, President Obama was the American president and Francois Hollande was the French president. When it concluded, he sent a draft to President Obama, kindly have a look at it and give your suggestions, if any. He gave something and then he asked him, have you talked to Narendra Modi ji? You must also take his views. For running the world, the view of India and Narendra Modi is important. So this is the kind of stature India has acquired. Next. One rank, one pension, surgical strike, I have told you, modernization of forces, that is going on. Next. Now, new might of a new India. PM has spoke, you know, the World Economic Forum, Davos. Now, how India has been included in many international bodies in the last 3.5 years, those we have mentioned. Next. Very Jai Vigyan, 104 satellites on one flight. 104 satellite on one flight, and they were from UAE, USA, all these things. So India has become a big satellite power also during the last 4 years. Next. Now farmers, next. Next. Now see, 11 lakh crore farm credit. 18-19 budget, we have announced that, before that kind of highest ever. 10,000 crore for infrastructure for fishery, aquaculture, animal husbandry. Tax incentive for promoting post-harvest agriculture activities. 2,000 agriculture market infrastructure fund. And National Bamboo Mission, this is also a demand of Telangana, ki bamboos have been declared as a forest. Though bamboo can be used for a lot of other, I would say, products, enable poor people living in the hills. So now bamboo has been taken out of the forest produce list. It has led to a lot of new inventions. Next. Now, MSP 1.5 times on the kharif in comparison to last. Buffer stock of, you can say, dal, 20 lakh tons, and about pulses also procured. Next. 50,000 crore to be invested to achieve har khet ko pani. And to cover 28.5 lakh hectare under irrigation. 5,000 crore for micro irrigations and other things. Therefore, micro irrigation, major irrigation, all are there. Next. ENAM I talked about. 87.5 lakh farmers are digitally talking to 585 digital market to sell their produce. That is our achievement. Next. Now, in case of distress, you must suffer 50% of crop damage. We have reduced it to 33%. And other initiative we have taken, I need not explain that. Some of them are well known. Next. Now, fertilizer. Neem coat on urea. Why it is important? Chemical factory used to pilfer the fertilizer for their purpose. Okay? With neem coat installation, it becomes useless for them. The stress on whole fertilizer reduced. And this was pending for the last 14, 15 years. The lobbies were at work. We reduced it, and now fertilizer queue has vanished. Next. Next. Education, you may have seen so many Atal Tinkering Labs. Next now. Please. 7 IIIT, 7 IIM, 14 IITs, NIT, 103 Kendriya Vidyalaya, 62 Navodaya Vidyalaya, all in the last 3.5 years. And about from other research, you can see that scholarship was 7,000 to 80,000 per person for 5 years to innovation of the young mind that we are doing. Next. Now, startup movement. How is startup changing? And I compliment the city of Hyderabad also. A big CEO of a big IT company one day came to me. Mr. Minister, earlier when I used to go to IITs to campus selection, they used to run to my company, a well-known company. Now if I go, they say, I want to become a startup. I want to become a job giver and not a job seeker. That is the changing profile of India in the last 4 years. Next. Please, back. Now, funding the unfunded, the Mudra Yojana. We have given 12 crore Mudra loanees. 50,000, 5 lakh, 10 lakhs. Amount is now, it has closed to 3.5 lakh crore. It is also changing every day. And half of them are SC, ST, OBC, and minorities. This is how we have changing the funding the unfunded scenario. Yes. The skill development program, you can see that 13,000 training centers have been opened across PM Kaushal Kendra. 1 crore youngsters chief training. Next. New sportsman spirit is being promoted, Khelo India. And you may have seen India's performance in the latest Commonwealth Games, including my distinguished colleague in the parliament, Mary Kom, again won the gold. And so many young girls also became so prominent in the performance. Next. Go ahead. Maternity leave extended from 3 months to 6 months. It is rarely talked about. By law, we did it. The Poshan Abhiyan in districts are going on with convergence to enhance the health of women. Go ahead. Now, this Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. Sex ratio in 104 identified districts, and now they are rising enrollment is coming because of toilet facility, no dropout is there. But here I would like to address something to all, in particular to my women colleague journalists here. Gender justice is a part of the commitment of the Narendra Modi government. Today, Indian girls are working in the village, getting digitally empowered, and they are now flying fighter planes. Earlier, there was no permission for them to fly the fighter planes. The Narendra Modi government allowed that. And hardly a week ago, the naval lady officers have circled the entire globe in a simple yacht, and they have come back. And if you have noticed the 26th January parade this year, the BSF gents acrobatics on the motorcycle was changed to the ladies. And what a great change they showed. In 2015, when President Obama was the chief guest, there is a set pattern of the parade of 26th January. The PM said, no, Indian woman officers will lead this parade. The Defense Minister of India is a woman. The Foreign Minister of India is a woman. Many other distinguished political personalities are women. This is how we are giving importance to the woman power of India. Digitally, physically, equity, and also empowerment in the field of greater, tougher roles. That is our holistic concept of woman empowerment. Yes, go ahead, next. All the schemes are there. It is available to you. Skill supply, Nari Shakti. I just talked about the Common Service Center movement. There are 52,000 women VLEs who are empowering India in the rural India. Everywhere this stress is going on. Yes, next. Death penalty for rape in the event the victim is 12 years or below. We did that. And the bill could not be passed because of opposition hangama. We have got an ordinance for that. You have seen that. That is our commitment for our girl, child, and young. Triple talaq. And speaking in Hyderabad, I would like to speak it a little more eloquently. Triple talaq is neither an issue of religion or of faith or of worship. It is an only issue of gender justice, gender dignity, and gender equality. Now it is 70 years down the line. How is it that in spite of constitution, equality, Article 15, non-discrimination, you will say talaq, 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 and you go on the street? 22 Islamic countries, including Pakistan, Bangladesh, Afghanistan, have regulated triple talaq. But in India, people are playing the issue of secularism and communalism. It has been passed by the Lok Sabha, but today I would like to raise a question. Madam Sonia Gandhi is a woman, Mayawati ji is a woman, Mamta ji is a woman. Do you have some concern for the rights of the woman or not? I remember when I was moving it in the parliament in Lok Sabha, lots of women came to us, Mr. Minister, today is our 15th August, today is our Eid. The kind of discrimination we used to suffer. Now the argument is, if we go to jail, who will feed the family? I am asking a question, in case of dowry prohibition, domestic violence, or even in case of ordinary violence or crime, Muslims go to jail or not? Then you don't raise these questions. Why only in this? Triple talaq, 3 years period is a deterrent. And I can tell you, Supreme Court set it aside, Lok Sabha has passed it, yet triple talaq is going on, including in Telangana, UP and many states. About hundreds and hundreds of talaq are going on. This is not fair. We stand fully committed there. Next. Social justice, next. 95,000 crore budget has been given for SCST. Scholarship has risen, pre-matric scholarship have risen. For SC students, all income has been raised from 2 lakh to 5 lakhs. The holistic concept for SCST. Next. Now, special camps, all these things. We have changed the terminology also. And they will call handicapped. Okay? We have made Divyang, not Vikalang. Divyang to look future with hope. And today, new categories have been added. If you are an acid victim, you are also entitled to benefit. New forms of violence has also been added in the category. Next. Now, the Right of Disability Act, I told you, acid act with speech and language disability, all we have added. Next. SCST, we have, remember, 2015, we have reinforced the SCST Act. In many villages, you are not allowed to ride a horse in the marriage. You're not allowed to go to the village or the village pond. You can't give nominations. You can't file nomination. You can't propose. The Devadasis all have become penal in the amendment of 2015. Our commitment to the SCSC cause, STSC cause is complete. And nothing could be greater than the fact that my party has got the highest number of SCMPs, STMPs, SCMLAs and STMLAs. But when the occasion came, we made a distinguished public leader who was also from scheduled caste community as the President of India. That is how we work as far as our commitment is concerned. Next, Dr. Ambedkar, all the where he was born, where he studied in England, where he got the embraced Buddhism, where he passed away, all have been made a kind of extraordinary memorial because of our effort. And when I'm talking of Dr. Ambedkar, let me ask a question to to my journalist friends in Hyderabad. It's very important. Dr. Ambedkar died in 1956. He was given Bharat Ratna in 1989 when V.P. Singh government came to power and we were supporting it. Sardar Patel played a crucial role in Hyderabad, you all know it. The great son of India. He died in 1950. He was given Bharat Ratna in 1991, after 41 years. Maulana Azad, another distinguished son, died in 1959. He was given Bharat Ratna in 1992. Who was the Prime Minister in 1991? A Telugu Bidda Narasimha Rao. And if there would have been one from the family as the Prime Minister, the job of giving Bharat Ratna to all these three would have fallen upon Atal Bihari Vajpayee, and he gave to Lok Nayak Jayaprakash Narayan. Why this? Because they were critique of Nehruji. What is our view? You may have any difference of opinion, but those who have contributed for the country must be given the award. And here, I would like to give a very specific instance for my friends of Hyderabad. This whole Padma Shri Padma Award is now available for common people who are doing extraordinary work. Just one example. Karimul Haq was a tea garden mazdoor in Jalpaiguri in West Bengal. His mother passed away because ambulance could not reach the high hills to save her. He took a vow that now I will take all the people seriously ill on my motorcycle, strapping them with my waist. He is known as Ambulance Baba. He has saved 2,000 lives. One day the PMO rings him, you are so-and-so, you are doing this work. So you can understand, a mazdoor, the PMO talking, he said, now the Prime Minister will talk to you. And the PM said, Karimul, kaise ho? Achha kaam kar raha ho, Delhi aao, tumhe hum Padma Shri de rahe hain. He started crying. Common people's contribution is now being recognized for Padma Awards. This year, two ladies, one of Kerala, doing a great service for rendering Ayurvedic medicines in the rural forest areas of Kerala, Padma Shri. And one maid servant of Bengal, who seeing the plight of her people in village, Tinka Tinka Jodkar, she got a hospital med. She has been given Padma Shri also. Common people are being recognized in Modi's government. Next. Healthy India, I just told you some of things. Next. Ayushman Bharat, 5 lakh insurance every year to 50 crore people, is going to be launched very soon. Next. You can see antenatal checkup, pregnant women, all we have given. Next. Now the Poshan Abhiyan to reduce malnutrition. Next. Prices of cardiac stents and knee implants reduced by 50 to 70%. You can see the great benefit which has occurred to common people. 105 for essential medicine brought under control regime, saving 10,000 crores. And rest are all Jana Aushadhi Kendras are there, which is giving medicines. You go to the field and see their impact. Next. Now, Pradhan Mantri National Dialysis Program. Till now, 2.5 lakh patients have availed the service free of cost. Dialysis in case of kidney problem is a serious issue. So how we have addressed that for the poor is an issue for you. Next. Now, Mission Indradhanush, I have told you, all the tikas are being given. It is a complete success in the country, all we have done. Next. Infrastructure. 1 crore houses built for the poor. Next. Urban center, smart cities, our development is going on. About 2,01,979 crores is going to be spent to impact 10 crore Indians. It is in the process, you know that. I told you, national highway, 92,000 crore, now 1,22,000 crore when we came to power. And how many are being constructed? 12 kilometer per day in Manmohan Singh government, 27 kilometer per day in Narendra Modi government. Gram Sadak, it is enhanced, how much? 69 kilometer per day in 2013-14, now 134 kilometer per day. The speed and the scale. Next. The railways, you can see, from 7,600 to 9,528 kilometers. God change. Next. एयर ट्रैवल, पीएम ने कहा मैं चाहता हूं हवाई चप्पल वाले हवाई जहाज में उड़ें.
ओके,
वी हैव एडेड 25 न्यू एयरपोर्ट्स एंड लो कॉस्ट एयरलाइन उड़ान इज गोइंग टू बी लॉन्च सून एंड आई नो मेनी ऑफ द एयरपोर्ट्स इवन इन तेलंगाना आर गोइंग टू बी लिंक टू दैट. एंड वन डे पीयूष गोयल माई फ्रेंड रेलवे मिनिस्टर वॉज सेइंग आई एम हैविंग ए प्रॉब्लम रवि जी, व्हाट्स दैट, द नंबर ऑफ माई ए सी पैसेंजर इन द ट्रेन इज गोइंग डाउन एंड पीपल आर माइग्रेटिंग टू एयर ट्रैवल. गुड फॉर इंडिया, पुअर पीपल मस्ट हैव द एक्सेस टू फ्लाइट, दैट्स व्हाट वी हैव डन. नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट, होम बायर्स ट्रांसपेरेंट कोलोकुलेशन, ऑल दिस इन्वेस्टमेंट हैज ऑल्सो क्रॉस्ड 1 lakh crore फ्रॉम दिस. नेक्स्ट, नाउ सी इन्फ्लेशन अंडर कंट्रोल, फूड इन्फ्लेशन इज अंडर कंट्रोल एंड 7.4% GDP फोरकास्ट, इंडिया इकोनॉमिक पावर हाउस. नेक्स्ट, नाउ काइंडली सी इंडियाज GDP इज 31% एट द ग्रोथ रेट ऑफ करंट प्राइसेस एंड आवर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन टू द वर्ल्ड, इट वॉज 1.75% इन 2005, 2.43% 2013, नाउ 4 years 3.80% इज इंडियाज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन टू द वर्ल्ड GDP, दैट इज इकोनॉमिक फंडामेंटल. नेक्स्ट, GST, 1 crore ट्रेडर्स आर नाउ GST, दे आर रियलाइजिंग द वर्थ ऑफ GST. नेक्स्ट, बैंक रिफॉर्म्स, वी आर पुटिंग इन 2,11,000 crore, क्रेडिट ग्रोथ फॉर द जॉब क्रिएशन एक्सेट्रा. नेक्स्ट, लेबर वेलफेयर, यू कैन सी 1 crore पीपल गॉट एम्प्लॉयड प्रोविडेंट फंड इंश्योरेंस अदर पेमेंट ऑफ वेजेस एक्ट एम्पावरिंग वर्कर्स, ऑल वी हैव बीन पास्ड, वी हैव पास्ड. नेक्स्ट, लीडिंग मोबाइल हब, आई टोल्ड यू इनिशियली फ्रॉम 2 to 120, 6 crore to 25 crore, एंड बाई नेक्स्ट ईयर 19-20 50 crore मोबाइल आर गोइंग टू मैन्युफैक्चर. And I'm going to make India's digital economy to a $1 trillion economy in the coming 5 to 7 years. That means huge amount. It will have potential of employment for 50 to 70 lakh people. And what I mean of digital economy, communication, IT, e-commerce, digital payment, electronic manufacturing, cyber security, new technology, all are part of digital economy. Next. Now India's rank in the ease of doing business, 42 points giant to 100 in 2 years' time. How India is being recognized globally. Next. Next. SIT was summit, demonetization. I have already talked about these things. I can skip that. Next. Double taxation agreement with Mauritius, Cyprus, Singapore, from where slush money used to come. Now we have made it tougher, complete information sharing. PMLA was amended. Black Money Undisclosed Foreign Assets Act was passed. Next. Fugitive Offenders Bill have been passed, confiscating their property in India, making life tougher for them. Next. Transparency, I have told you, 1 crore new taxpayers have been added in India's income tax scenario. So how technology is empowered, 1 crore GST, 1 crore income tax. Next. I told you how auction everything is, cronyism is out, cleanliness is in. Next. Yes. I just told you from National Highway to Optical Highway to everything, construction going on. Next. From railway safety, steps are being taken, reduction is going in accidents. Next. I told you Sochalaya, Common Service Center, how the people are being connected to this whole movement. Last. Now kindly see, pre-GST 55 lakh number of taxpayer registered. Post GST 1 crore. How change occurs if you make it transparent? Next. 23.83 crore LED bulbs distributed, which is more than the population of Brazil, to poor people. Next. Now, financial inclusion, bank account, everything I have said. That's all. These I have spoken. Go to next. Yes. Come back on last. This is income tax people filing income tax return, ITR. 3.79 crore 13-14, 6.84 crore 17-18. That's all. Now, friends, my concluding remarks before I take questions. I will never say India has completely developed. But what we have achieved clearly indicates India is on a path of path of great development with hope and with commitment. And this process we are going to continue further. We are very proud of the leadership of the Prime Minister and the way we are working and engaging with the people, taking feedbacks. I'll be meeting editors today, other people today, IT people today, I'll be meeting them. One last question upon jobs. Let me give some statistics for that. First, in my IT ministry, 39.89 or 90 lakh people work directly in IT. 39 lakhs, 90,000 around. Direct. 39.90 lakhs. And one third are indirect because of that. The system, the services. That is about 1 crore 25 to 30 lakh people work indirectly. And again, for my women journalist, one third are women. 39.9 lakh directly, 1 crore 25 to 1 crore 3 lakh indirectly. I have just said in electronic manufacturing, 4.5 lakh people in mobile only in the last 4 years. And if you add the other LED bulb, others, it will cross 5.5 lakhs. In my common service centers, 2,91,000 all over the country, 10 lakh people are working. BPOs in a small towns, I just told you. This is my IT department. In the last 3 years, as per NASSCOM estimate, 6 lakh IT professionals have got jobs. And in 17-18, 1 lakh people have got jobs. March till. Others are being calculated. Now, I just told you, Mudra, 12 crore people have been granted 5.8 lakh crore, close to 6 lakh crore plus. Now, if out of these 12 crore people, even half have given job to one, to expand their business, how many people have got jobs? 3 to 4 crore to 5 crore to 6 crores. Roads are being constructed with great speed. Are the laborers getting job or not? Rural roads are being constructed with great speed. Are the workers getting job or not? Electrification, Skill India, Digital India program, startup movement. Therefore, jobs are created because economy is smiling, because investment is coming, because services are changing. For instance, we have made e-visa, 161 country, and the number of tourists coming to India has risen by 30%. 10 lakh tourists are coming per month. How it is changing? Therefore, the entire ecosystem is creating more and more jobs. Yes, once India's economy grows further, it is bound to be there. Therefore, friends, the 4 years have been years of hope, years of challenges, years of aspirations, and years of commitment. That's what we are doing. I'll seek your suggestions also. And if more active march is required to be done, this government will never at all falter. There is a message for us by our leader, the Prime Minister. Treat every Sunday as a Monday. And that's how we are working. Thank you.